Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff tunes the nose region, including adjusting the envelope weighting in the nostril area.
Okay, so next down the line here is the nose area. We've already done a little envelope correction on this for the bridge to look better, but you'll notice now at the base, it's moving way too much there, so we're going to want to adjust that. And one thing to notice on this, if you go into Maps, Envelope Weight, Paint Mode, got a solo mode here. The nose is weighted almost entirely to this pivot up here, and so smoothing isn't really going to have much of an effect here, as there's not much left to smooth to. So I'm going to just assign some of the weight back to that head null, which is that cross in the center, and just give it a stable, you know, place to blend into. So let me get my weights up. So if I just kind of get that stabilized a bit that way, and that should kind of lock down the edge of the nose there, so you can start to smooth that out nicely and get a nice fall off. So that's not bad. Now one thing you may be thinking is, well, you've just messed up all the weights on the upper lip by, you know, weighting them all to that head and all. But in this case, it doesn't really matter because the mouth area is all controlled by the mouth operator. And so all this envelope weighting that you see here, it doesn't really matter. Anywhere where, if you go back to the mouth tab and the paint mouth blending, anywhere where you're in the blue here, the enveloping doesn't factor in. It's all the operator for the mouth controlling that. And as you get closer into the black areas, the weighting picks up again. So most of all that area that we just painted blue is going to get its influence from the mouth control anyway. So just go back to that. If I grab that upper lip and start to move it around, you can see it gets all of its information from the mouth operator anyway, so we're fine there. Yeah, snapping on. So you don't have to worry too much about messing up these weights around the mouth, the lips especially, because they don't really factor into the final result. So that's got the nose tip in pretty good shape. Now the thing you're going to want to do if your animation is detailed enough that things like nostril flares are going to be obvious, you may want to adjust the enveloping on those a bit. By default, as you can see, if you really pull it too far, you start to see a lot of pulling on the upper lip area where there shouldn't really be much. So you can tighten that up pretty easily. If you go back into envelope weight paint, you can see, if I go underneath here and move this controller, you can kind of see what's going on. There's these four boxes which represent the nostril ring, and then there's a line on top of deformers that just kind of controls the volume of that nostril flare. So I will usually go in here and just kind of redo all that stuff. It's a little broad right now, and it's getting down here way too far. So let's just go in there and kill what's there on some of those deformers. And let me go into solo mode here. Pick this guy. Let me turn symmetry off. So you can see it's got some some weight down here that it doesn't really need. 100%. Just erase. In fact, I'll just erase all of it and just start over. A lot of these don't even really have much effect. That one had quite a lot. Now, areas like this, where this vert was 100% weighted to that deformer, since it's in the mouth area, you don't have to worry about it, because the mouth controller is going to win on those verts anyway. If you really want to, you can go in there and assign that back to the head null or something, but that's not going to pull. In fact, if you pull this around, you'll see those verts don't move anyway, because they're controlled by the mouth operator. So these are kind of back where they should be here. Okay, so I'll leave those there. And I'll just redo these, the rings. And I usually, on this deformer, I usually don't even use it, because as you can see, when you pull this, it tends to kind of rotate around. I tend to just leave that kind of out of the mix for the most part, because I don't want this to move too much in here. But if you want a little of that kind of rolling from the inside, you can add some back into that. So let me just start painting these guys back. Get out of solo mode. Now just smooth that over. See what that looks like. So that's better as far as just controlling the right part of the nostril. Now I'm getting a little too much pulling in there, so I can go in there and smooth that out a bit more. So that's a little better. Still probably could use some more tweaking on that, but at least you're not getting anything down on the upper lip now, and it feels a little more like a nostril flare would. So I'll do that same thing to this side. And see how that looks. It's a little heavy there. That's okay for this. And then while I'm at it, I'll go ahead and smooth these weights around here just in case something shows. Okay, and that should have everything behaving pretty well in the nose area. And then one final thing to note in here is if you select one of the nostril bulge controls and go under its selection, you'll see that you get this nostril bulge influence property. And you can control exactly how that tries to follow other controls. So if I move the nose, notice that they try to kind of follow a bit. And if you want, you can pull the influence from the tip of the nose down to nothing, and then any movement is reduced. It still will rotate from that. And then if you pull this base, like a sneer kind of control, it tries to track in between those, and you can reduce that to nothing as well. So you can control exactly how that tries to behave in relation to other controls